ist was dem, was ich gucke ist today. Und schlägt.
Hello everybody, Bumchef is back, this time with Oatflakes. So, this are they. Inpatients get feeded with it, like orphans, criminals in prison, but I will show you that you can do even more with them. What we will do today is cover schnitzel with them. Schnitzels are usually covered in breadcrumbs. That's this stuff. But we will take oat flakes to cover them up. First thing, we heat up some oil in two separate pans because we need two pans for today's dish. The side dish will be beans, like not those American beans, where a single bean is bigger than your thumb. But so-called Buschbohnen, German Buschbohnen. This is a single bean. Focus? Will it focus? I don't know, maybe too tiny. Coming out of this thing, and this is why we will fry them on the whole length. But we will wrap them in bacon. Okay. First, we will cover the meat. It's a simple thing. Always start with what takes the longest. Easy. And those schnitzel are too thick. Yes, there is something like too thick. So we tenderize them with our meat tenderizer. If you don't have something like this, you could use a pan. Use a pan and smash the meat with this. I won't show this now because the last time I did this, after this third hit, the pan broke and I was only swinging the grip. Okay, it just came to my mind that if you want to heat something up, you need heat. Now for the beans, we just cut off the ends, up and down end. If you are a hipster or some paranoid maniac, you could wash them, but those get heated up on 200 degrees Celsius and every germ dies by heating those up. So why wash them? Okay, now that this is done, we're gonna wrap them up. The bacon is nothing special, just simple, really soft, smoked breakfast bacon. It's pretty small, so I take two side by side. And about 1 handful of beans like this. This is a much. And it should look like this. Because of all the fat, it should stick together just fine without any additional wraps or strings or whatever. Okay, once the oil has its highest temperature, we reduce the heat to middle heat. Don't make those rolls too big because the beans in the middle won't get any heat if it's too big. Now let's make the magic happen and okay, that was the fire alarm. Nothing special happens all the time. It's getting a little hot in here. The three things you need to cover meat is flour, eggs, and normally you would use breadcrumbs, but we use oat flakes. Now we spice things up with pepper and salt, nothing special. The spices are getting mixed into the flour. Use a fork to mix this spices up and the eggs. Okay, and now we cover the meat. First, the flour. When it's all white, not all right, all white, the flour makes the meat so sticky that the egg stays on it, and the eggs make the meat so sticky the crumbs or oat flakes stay at it. Cover it all up. And into the pan it goes. Afterwards your fingers will look like this. Now you can go to a doctor and tell your boss, oh man, I'm sick for the next 5 weeks, or you wash them. Now the first thing you want to do when shortly after adding them to the pan, into the oil, is moving the pan. Just move it around a bit. Let me tell you a secret. The only thing you have to pay attention when frying something is flip it over only once. One time. This is not Bikini Bottom, I'm not SpongeBob, and I won't stay on the oven and flip it all the time over and over again. This either burns it, or it takes 5 hours for a simple schnitzel like this to become nice and brown, or you will burn it in the end, or it will suck up all the oil, because each time you flip it over, there's a thick level of oil covering the side, and if you flip it over, it sinks into the meat. And if you flip it again, there's again this a new level of oil, and it will sink into the meat again every time. And what you will get in the end is a fat sponge, and it will taste like nothing but fat. So whatever you fry, burger, schnitzel, cat tails, flip it only once. You can take a look at it from time to time, lift it a bit, take a look underneath it, but don't flip it before it's totally ready from the downside. And now we wait. Okay, I'm back. It's time to flip them over. And as you can see, I bought some potatoes. I almost forget about them. We will simply cook them as some additional side dish to stuff yourself. Just half them or quarter them if they are bigger than this. And of course we leave the peel on it because of all of the vitamins. Vitamin P, for example. P like potatoes. And don't forget about the vitamin S in the schnitzel. There's nothing more to cooking potatoes than slicing them up. Looking for the salt. There it is. Adding some salt. And some water. That's it. Now that we flipped over the schnitzel and readied the potatoes, not just ready, turn it on, It's time to fry the bean wraps. And they have the same rule, flip them only once. So while everything is now cooking, I will clean up this mess. Okay, everything is ready. Another basic for you to know. How do you know when the potatoes are ready? Just take a fork or a sharp knife and stick it into it. When it gets really easy and you can pick up the potato and it flies away, the potatoes are ready. Now you will get rid of the water. Take out a few. And those are ready when they look like this, having the best color in the world, brown. And same goes for the schnitzel. Now if you're missing a sauce, well, you have to look elsewhere. I'm really bad at cooking sauces. Now let's give it a taste. First the beans. This is how they should look. Hot, but perfectly tasty. They don't need additional spices. The bacon is salted in the process of smoking, smoked bacon, and that's totally enough. When the bacon becomes brown, the beans get cooked just the right way. They are not too soft and they are not raw anymore. Very good. Okay, potatoes. Nothing special. Of course. If I didn't mention, it's pork. Happy pigs, I guess. Yeah, and that's how it looks. Nice white meat, white pork meat, and great. Try this. Try to cover your meat instead of breadcrumbs in oat flakes. And remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.